care. Yeah. Can't be on the phone. That's just how we was.
Yeah.
They were so cute.
Yeah. And one thing we do, Mom, and guys, I think we can do this. I always, on their birthdays, let them say one positive thing about their classmate to celebrate. Oh. So let's do it, okay? Okay, I'm going to start with loving. Beautiful, loving child that I'm so blessed and forever humbled to be his teacher. You know, and I love you very much. And together, it was, I'll never forget. Okay? You have a special word? How would you describe him?
Comedy.
Comedy. With a capital C.
Yes.
Lyle?
Very, very funny.
Very, very funny.
He's very historic. He would always call me Potbelly.
Madam Cachet, who girls hold up your fingertips. And Dr. Gregor, he did one. Oh, she did our nails.
Oh, yes.
We have
them. She did one.
They went around.
Oh, yeah.
So, yeah, she set up her shop over here. Okay. For blue nails, come on over.
And, she's talented.
Oh, I already knew that. She's painted some borders on my room. Oh. She's very talented. Okay, beautiful.
Oh, he was very overprotective over all of us. Anytime I would try to go out the room, hey, Mackenzie, where are you going? I think he was very sweet and funny because he and overprotective because like every time like we're like Mackenzie said, every time we go somewhere, he's like, where are you going? And we say where are we going, and he's like, oh.
and I told you that when I have pictures to give you down the road, when we would take pictures, I would say, go over there, guys, and take a picture. And most kids just lean on each other, but with Drew, you'll see in the pictures, his arms wrapped. So he's holding, and then his classmates, and there's a picture with me. He's literally holding me. He's not just leaning. You know? And that was him. Yeah. You know? That's what I would
love to say. Thank you so much.
I know you're gonna say it, Tommy. I didn't mean to put you on the spot.
Right. I told Mom. I said, I'm pulling it together. Yeah. I'm pulling it together. Yes.
But she's the one that told us about the fun.
Thank you.
And
we have a bouncy house.
I know.
Face painting.
I just want to say, you know, just being here at Graham School, you know, for the 11 years, and I lost Amoya, and now I've lost Drew. And I just want to say, Drew has just changed my life. He just loved to come. You just need to know. He loved to come in my office. Loved to come in my office with a few other students. Once he realized that I would stop and I would listen to him. Mm-hmm. And so he would just knock on the door and say, Dr. McGregor, can I share something with you? And he would read his poems, or he would tell me about how well he did on his tests. Yeah. Sometimes I would come in and I'd check up on him and everything with some of the other kids, and he would say, I'm listening, I'm doing good. I did all my work, you know? So he always loved for you to be know that and to be proud of him, you know?
I do good.
Yes. And that really meant a lot, you know? He has such a presence. Mm. And I feel so blessed that you shared your baby with us.
Yes.
And I call them my babies and my Graham stars. But that day, I feel extremely, extremely happy that I got to spend that little bit of time with him. Because as I shared, that day of dismissal, I'm usually in the auditorium with the Strong program. But that day, I was outside on the sidewalk, and Drew and a couple other students were playing over on the bench. And I said, get over here, you guys, get over here. And I would sit right here next to me. And he came over there. I wasn't doing anything. I said, it's okay, but sit right here, you're gonna sit here anyway. And so we got to spend that 15, 20 minutes together before I went inside. But it is just to see how he has impacted our lives. If we could just be half that, right? And leave that legacy behind and that impact on our folks and that love, you know, that's what I strive for. So it makes everything that I do here and my purpose for what I do just mean so much more.
And he taught me. So you taught me so much about giving. You really did.
Thank you.
You just gave and gave and gave to me and my class every day. I was telling Mom that, you know, I get my behavior book, he'd run up and give it to me, and then I go to read it and then look, he's watching me, you know. And I go and I open it and I get my either beautiful quote or my letter or my boost for the day brought to me, and I would tell him that too. What is for me? And so I read it, and it was always something inspirational or funny. And then I close and go, oh, I just love your mother. And he would just smile, you know. And the day that, just to say with Dr. DeBrager, because she does not ever turn her babies away. Mm. The day we did poetry, and he was the first one done, he printed it out, he said, can I go shoot Dr. DeBrager? And now, you know, the schools, I'll be honest, you know, I don't always say that to the principal, because principals are busy. So normally I would say to my kids, all right, just put it in a folder, we'll show it later.
Right.
But not Dr. McGregor. She doesn't turn her babies away. Yeah. And she turns her teachers away. She's sometimes, LaBella, not now, and I'm usually in there advocating for these guys. Well, they need this, and they need that.
Yeah.
But the babies, I'm always free to just say, when they say, can I go to Dr. Greger? I just let them go. Because
yes.
I know she's going to be...
Yes.
I think you had your hand up first, right? You can talk to Mom.
I would say he had a very, similar personality. He had, an affectionist person.
Oh, thank you.
Okay, Hunter?
So, after he gets his book from you, he'll go downstairs and be like, oh, what did Mr. Miller write in my book?
That was a smart thing to do.
I wouldn't tell if it was bad.
That's right.
We kept connected.
Yeah,
whether it was
text
the book or the texting, and he was stuck to it.
Yeah.
He couldn't.
Miss LaBella, to speak to who Miss LaBella is, Drew had a stomach virus, a cold or something.
That.
And she wanted me to take him to the doctor, and on the weekend, she wanted to check on how he was doing.
Yeah.
And I'm just like, to be a teacher, even when you're off, is awesome. And she just wanted to know if he was doing better and feeling better, and she missed him. And that's going above and beyond.
Yes.
You know, you got 22 babies, so.
Well, you know, it's funny you say that, because remember we talked, and he never was sick. So
every day
was brightness, smile, happiness. And Bella, you know. But then that one day, he just came in, and he just had this look.
Yeah.
His eyes were different. And I just knew. You know, like a mom myself, I called you and you're like, well, that's true.
You know,
he's never sick, but if he's sick, he's really sick.
Well, he's not even a problem.
Yeah. Or joking.
Yeah.
I just wanted to take a moment.
Yes.
I just looked inside and I just, thank you so much, Nadine. I don't know if you guys, I don't even know what to say. To say a connection at this moment in this way. But Miss Nadine Shamoya's mom and Colby, we have been friends ever since.
Oh,
and she said, I want to come and
thank
I just want to give mom a hug and embrace her.
Oh,
so.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
That's Shamoya. She has it. She lost her
daughter. Thank you. Yes.
Yeah.
I
started out in Shamoya's play on the GMA.
Yes.
So you was a boy that I loved.
Yeah. Thank you.
For the people. I know your pain.
Oh.
I pray for you.
Thank
you. And he's an angel. Just prepare yourself to meet him one day.
Yes.
You know, so.
Listen.
I know. And
thank you.
I didn't want to come before time because I know I'm hurting because I knew him.
Yeah.
And then she pleaded so much because all of them are her babies.
Yeah.
And when she hurts, I'm going to be hurt because I know what she's going through.
Yeah.
And we're all here for you.
Thank you.
For the team. So we're here.
Thank you.
All right.
Appreciate it. Thank you, guys.
We'll still be outside with you.
Yeah, we're going to go outside.
And happiness and love and peace. And so we'll meet you outside. They have, you know what? Drew's mom's going to be
outside.
Tell her outside. Yes, we're going to be outside. DeAndre?
I remember this time yesterday when I was trying to figure out what song to tell my mom. Okay, she was asking me what song to choose, and then my dad went to get something for me from school tomorrow, and then it just came on the radio.
Your favorite song? What was it?
Hello, Dr. McGregor, are you there?
Yes, we're coming downstairs.
Yes, they asked me for you outside.
Yes, we are. We're on our way.
As women, we gotta stick together.
Every single solitary time he'd come in my room, whether to hand me something or whatever, he just, Drew, what's up, Drew? Drew? Just Drew. That's it. He always had to make a comment to Drew every single time. They were like buddies.
Yeah.
Nobody else. Just Drew. So he would turn around, look at him, and he'd be like, Drew.
9-1-4.
Right? Every time.
Yeah,
5-1-3.
Yeah.
6-6. My man.
Thank you. Coming outside.
It's been a very gloomy week.
I thought I was
We're mourning the loss of Drew.
I didn't know how to get on the bag.
Today marks his 10th birthday. All the rain and storm that we've had all week, today as we decide to remember remember Drew on his 10th birthday. The sun is shining, no doubt. That's Drew shining down on us to make sure that the day is special. So I want to say happy birthday to Drew. I want to also send my deepest condolences to the family. And a special condolences to the Graham School community, Dr. Hunter and Gregory in particular. This community has had its share of grief, and they continue to rise above it. So may God bless you and continue to smile.
Now it's DJ Sanzi on the ones. Hi. I'll be back with the update. I'll get you in a minute.
That's good.
Make some noise for Drew. Come on, make some noise for Drew. Make some noise, make some noise, make some noise. Make some noise, make some noise. Hold on, wait. Hold on the count of three, I want everybody to say that at the loudest. Happy birthday, on the count of three. You guys ready? Hold on. One, two, three. Hold on. I didn't hear the whole part. I want to hear the whole part say happy birthday, Drew. At the count of three. One, two, three. Happy birthday, Drew! Ciao, we hear some song now. Come on, Mr. I said, like, you know, I'm a Jamaican, right? I'm a Caribbean American, you know? I said, I like the way you look at me. Yes. No.
I love the way you hold my hand.
Enjoy yourself tonight. Hey, come on. And then,
the way you take me today. The way you carry me today.
We have some fun tonight. Let's go.
You're pulling me up. Every day you are pulling me up. You're telling me up. Anytime I look at you, you're
pulling
me up. You're taking me up. The way you want to take me slow. You're killing me up.
We got your circle lovers in here today. Got a little bit of everything for you. Look at mine. Who remember? I did not say that.
Some of them never know me.
I did not say some of them never know me.
Some of them keep for me. Every time the people jump in, some of them wanna wine for me.
Yeah.
Some of them boogie down for me. We love the way the ladies wine for me.
Hell, everybody know. Yeah.
Back up. Everybody go. I like the way you do it.
A DJ hype is on the set, but then I said, money.
All right, brother, appreciate it.
Hi, world. We're here to celebrate my friend June because, I don't want to talk about it. Anyway, so we're here having a good time, eating food, listening to music, dancing. My friend Malia just won a dance battle. It was so fun. It was Jamaican versus Jamaican, not to be racist, though. So don't think of it as a bad way. So it was awesome. Mine.
We're gonna send you over there by the cake, but look, I just want to make sure y'all know that Mount Vernon is here with you, and I hope you're having a good time celebrating Drew's life and his birthday. And we're gonna go sing "Happy Birthday" in a minute, right, Brianna? And I heard that some of y'all are gonna go to the circus. Is that right? Oh my goodness. Well, look. We're gonna sing "Happy Birthday" to Drew. Where's the cake? The cake is all the way over there.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday.
side. Go that side. They're gonna cut the cake, so they want you to go that side. She wants to play one more song for Drew. Let me hear you scream for Drew! One, two, three. Happy birthday!